Item number, SCP-023. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-023 is to be contained in a walled-off intersection of two corridors at site, with at least 3 meters of space in each direction, and false doors at 3 of the 4 ends, in addition to the real door. Security cameras will be placed and maintained above all 4 doors. At all times, SCP-023's eye sockets are to be filled with spherical inserts made of hard rubber. Eye inserts must be replaced as they degrade. Degradation can be monitored by measuring the brightness of the burning effect, as observed by security footage. Brightness greater than 12 candela requires that the inserts be replaced within 12 hours. Eye inserts are only to be replaced individually, and only after the sun is completely set. Personnel are not to look directly into eye sockets of SCP-023 at any time. Following Incident 023-27, all reflective surfaces, including displays, monitors, and eyewear of any sort, are not permitted within 30 meters of SCP-023's cell. This includes monitors linked to security cameras within its enclosure. Security personnel posted at checkpoints outside both corridors will enforce and adhere to this measure. Experimentation involving SCP-023 has been suspended indefinitely. Description: SCP-023 is a large, sexless, shaggy canine, 1.5 meters at the shoulder, with black fur. The following text has been struck through. It has bright orange-red eyes and prominent teeth, and of strike-through. Anytime an individual makes eye contact with SCP-023, either that person or a member of their immediate family will die exactly 1 year after eye contact is broken. Research into the method of selection is incomplete due to a moratorium on experiments, but the available data suggests that having a larger immediate family lessens the chance of the individual making eye contact themselves dying, and neither a pattern nor a preference in victim types have been found. This may indicate that SCP-023's victim is designated entirely at random, but it is unknown whether this selection occurs at the beginning or at the end of the 1 year time period. Attempts to terminate an individual who has made eye contact with SCP-023 and their entire immediate family before the 1 year time period has ended, data expunged. Autopsies of individuals killed by SCP-023's effect show that, while outwardly appearing unharmed, their remains have been filled in with highly compacted ash, including but not limited to all organ systems and the circulatory system. Muscle tissue, bones, and brain tissue universally show signs of exposure to temperatures above degrees Celsius. If not contained in a setting that at least superficially resembles a crossroads, SCP-023 will phase through walls to get to the nearest suitable location, incinerating all materials it passes through. SCP-023 was first brought to the Foundation's attention when it attacked a church and while it was in session, killing civilians directly and as a result of eye contact. Following retrieval of SCP-023, Class B amnestics were administered to all witnesses and surviving victims. The incident was covered up as a case of arson. Incident Report 023-026. SCP involved, SCP-023. Personnel involved, Dr. 5D class personnel. Date: location: site. Description: in an attempt to curtail the danger posed by SCP-023, Dr. has approved the removal of both 023's eyes and teeth. Immediately after both its eyes were removed, SCP-023 breached security by vanishing completely. SCP-023 was reobtained on a stretch of interstate at 4:37 p.m. and brought back into containment, where D-class personnel finished pulling out its teeth. While the total number of civilians exposed to SCP-023 during this period is unknown, death record monitoring has tied 9 civilian deaths to this incident. Timestamps confirmed over the course of the next 48 hours that SCP-023 vanished only while the sun was visible in the sky from outside site. Addendum 023-026-1. As of, Dr. has been suspended, pending disciplinary review for contributing to, if not being directly responsible for, Incident 023-026. Dr. Shepard is now in charge of SCP-023. The increased difficulties in containment that have been incurred as a result of Dr. should serve to remind all personnel of the Foundation's purpose: secure, contain, and protect. Research, experimentation, convenience, and even the safety of Foundation personnel are secondary concerns. We are not working to protect ourselves. 05. Addendum 023-026-2. A total of bodies, with a time of death exactly 1 year after Incident 023-26, have been identified as consistent with SCP-023 exposure. Incident Report 023-27. SCP involved, SCP-023. Personnel involved, Dr. Data expunged. Date. Location. Site. Description. Timeline of events. 10 seconds. A pair of glass eyeballs are inserted into the eye sockets of SCP-023 by two D-class personnel. 15 seconds. Glass eyes take on an orange-red glow, similar to what SCP-023's real eyes looked like before removal. 3 minutes and 13 seconds. Molten glass begins to run out of SCP-023's eye sockets. 5 minutes and 54 seconds. Data expunged appear on all lenses, windows, mirrors, monitors, and glass surfaces at site. 6 minutes and 12 seconds. Evacuation of site ordered. 6 hours, 54 minutes and 7 seconds. Sun visible over horizon. D-class personnel sent in to check area around SCP-023's enclosure. Data expunged, gone. Only trace of SCP-023 is a burnt section of floor around a puddle of colored glass. Personal log of Dr. Date. It's my fault. I have doomed my research team, and possibly the rest of the facility. All that's left is to keep trying. We must contain SCP-023. Note, on 1 year after Incident 023-27, personnel were interred in an unmarked mass grave outside Site. Addendum 023-001. SCP-023 broke containment on by passing through its cell wall. Incident 023-01. SCP-023 was later discovered at the intersection of two corridors elsewhere on site. Agent noted SCP-023's similarity to a special containment procedure for SCP-023 updated. Assistant researcher issued a reprimand for negligence. Addendum 023-002. SCP-023 has been responsible for the deaths of personnel and civilians since it was first brought into containment on 10-12-94. Addendum 023-003. Request for reclassification to Keter pending. Addendum 023-004. Due to both anomalies focusing on specific geographic spaces, their destructive capabilities, and canine appearance, it is possible that SCP-1111-1 may be a variant of the same phenomenon observed in SCP-023, or vice versa. Investigation into the origin of both anomalies is ongoing, due to the inability to capture SCP-1111-1 for study. Investigations are currently focused on SCP-023. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-022, The Morgue, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.